Hi everyone, welcome back to Divinity Original Sin. And poof, there's Ken.
I was here all along.
So Ken, I learned something very important.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, you know that witchcraft ability I was looking for, the bloodletting?
Yeah?
It isn't in Enhanced Edition.
What?
Yeah, I looked up basically, I was like thinking of interesting builds to do before we did this LP. And someone's like, oh, you do, like, leech when you step on blood, and then you get bloodletting as witchcraft, and then it's, like, amazing. You heal yourself while you're in combat. Yeah, they removed it because it was so overpowered, so. Go figure, huh?
Wow, getting nuffed.
Yeah, I know. Anyways, we're in the lighthouse, which is the destination of our thing, so. The whole thing with the lighthouse is that it's been on despite the fact there's been, like, a giant monster with bagpipes in front of it this entire time, so. What has been keeping the lighthouse active? And the answer is a spooky ghost, apparently.
What's this? Living eyes that can see the shape of death? Avert your gaze, wanderer, for you are looking upon the phantom of a murderer.
Tell me about yourself.
Samson was my name a long time ago. I know not why upon my death I became a ghost, doomed to haunt this tower. Perhaps the gods heard of my crime and stripped me of my rightful place in their eternal realm. If so, their punishment was just. Each night, I wake the flame in the lighthouse to repent for my wretched sin.
You called yourself a murderer, why?
That indeed is the tainted title I must bear, and deservedly so. For 15 years ago to the day, it was that I sat atop my lighthouse, the flame unlit, and watched on as a pitiable ship crashed upon the cliff and got devoured by greedy waves. Deliberately, had I foregone to do my duty. Willfully, did I condemn every soul aboard to a salty sleep on the bed of an indifferent sea.
Why did you do it?
Why did I commit this act of blackest horror? Jealousy, anger, the bitter anguish of a broken heart. Those are the ancient ills that drove me to madness. Desdemona was on board, as I knew she would be, my wife. The delicate beauty of whom I was sure was betraying me with her friend, the dashing Falinor. Possessed as I was by the demons of envy, ire, and torment. I decided that if I had her love no longer, only death could take her for his mistress. And so I sat here, coldly and calmly, as I delivered them both unto the deep. Yet no sooner had the water closed its spuming jaws around the perishing vessel below, than the extent of my offense dawned on my beleaguered mind. Overcome with guilt, I sought escape through the hangman's noose. But rest was not to come.
I heard there might be an undead lair here. Do you know anything about that?
Skeletons roam the lands, restless as my troubled soul. But shall not find their lair here. Some scuttle by now and again. But most of the time, I reside here in solitude. Solitude and silence.
I'll take my leave. Okay, so creepy ghost.
Another betrayed soul. It is weakness that he weeps for her. Her death was deserved.
Speaking of deserved deaths, will you can it, or do I need to can you?
Thanks, Medora.
Quite a story that ghost had to tell. Not every day one hears about a lighthouse keeper sinking ships just because his wife proved to be unfaithful.
Aye, a pitiful creature. Torn up so badly by the loss of love that it led him to commit murder. I almost feel sorry for him.
Yes, I understand. Despite his heinous act, one can't but commiserate with his plight. Nothing more bitter than love undone.
Actually, I don't give a fuck, but I think forgiving gives us something better.
The ship, the waves,
where's forgiving?
The cold, wild sea.
We get a chance to hit bonus of 20% attack of opportunity, which is something we don't care about.
Actually, I think in that case I prefer forgiving, because I don't get attack of opportunity.
Exactly. Usually the nice stuff, like, oh, the dick stuff is usually stuff you do as a thief, and then the nice stuff is someone you do as, like, I don't know what. I don't think we have anything else up here. I was just seeing if I could see the top of the lighthouse. Just having a look around here to see if, Alright, I guess we might as well go back to town and finish the murder of who killed Counselor Jake.
The murder of who killed Counselor Jake?
Who killed...
Excellent English.
Isn't that English? It's English.
Murder of who killed Counselor Jake.
So, we talked to Arhu. Okay, so by the way, the ship that the ghost was referring to, I mean, we talked to Unsinkable Sam, which was that cat, which because we have the pet pal trait. Now, was are those related to two sunken ships? Who even knows? They're probably related. But, yeah, we'll probably get to do both those quests all in one go. But our good friend Arhu told us to go talk to the mortician. And so that's what we're going to do now. And also, Kand, I think, has been wanting to go into this place for a while.
Yes.
Let me go up here and talk to him. By the way, there's 9-inch nails on the ground. Right. Let me save this up before we have to do
so,
snow.
What's the bad news? More orcs rampaging through the docks? Or have those infernal statues sent another soul flying to his death?
What can you tell me about Jake's murder?
Sad story, that. Though if I'm speaking plainly, the sentimental aspect of it all doesn't make much of an impression on an undertaker. Especially not these days, with so many laid low by the orcs and such like. I just concern myself with giving the remains a respectable exit from life. We set him to rest in the northern graveyard. Perhaps he can finally get a little peace.
About Jake's body.
What about it? Didn't I just say we gave it a respectable send-off? Why are you giving me the third degree? Now, if you don't mind, I'm trying to run a business here.
Oh, and... Okay, so... He's kind of... telling us, you know, it's not that suspicious. He's like, who gives a shit about the body, basically? Like, he gave it a send-off, that's pretty much it. What'd you get?
Plus one leadership hat. Do you want that?
I guess so, sure.
Does Johan have a hat?
Actually, he doesn't. Give it to Johan. Johan doesn't have anything. Poor Johan. Johan now has more leadership, which means that when people see him, they like him. Or something.
There you go, Mike. That's one for you.
It gives a boost initiative and damage. I mean, we could make someone, one of our party members, have high leadership. I don't know who it would be, though. I mean, technically, it should be one of us, because I get plus one leadership. Here, maybe it should be canned.
I think we make him a door, that actually.
That's a nice wand, actually. Fuck.
I'm thinking of going in there and raiding the trophy. Yeah, I'm gonna do it.
I'm gonna give you a wand to sell, because you're the selling guy now.
I know, I'm resigned to my fate. I'm also the stealing guy.
I have not used any of these, like...
Oh, that's what.
There's also an identifying glass there. Do you see that guy? Or do you have one already?
I gave one to you, because I figured you had it now.
Oh yeah, I do. Okay, so this lets us identify things a lot better, actually. I think that's what it does. I don't quite remember. I don't have it too.
But anyway, amulet hype. Oh, fuck. You're welcome.
Plus one intelligence, reflect 10% melee damage as fire damage. Oh yeah, that's definitely for me. This is definitely a thing. Alright, I'm gonna go through some things over here. Oh, nothing here. Take the empty potion bottle. Corpse compendium.
If only the popular girls from the Source Academy could see how edgy and dangerous you've become.
I really should have a look at that. Oh, wait, what the hell? Crack it open. The Corpse Compendium. Volume 1.
Striking it rich! Orcs.
Chapter 2, Orcs. They kind of talk about...
Passing you a book.
Yeah. Alright, the guy came down, by the way. Robert's Ledger. Furthermore, I find it impossible that anyone but Major Cecile... Cecile, sorry, I don't know how to fucking say his name. could be able to get... Okay, so... Furthermore, I find it possible that anyone but Major Cecile, Captain Aris, Evelyn, or Esmeralda would have been able to gain access to the body without noticing. A corpse can't just vanish into midair. Even if it could, it's not a strong enough wind. So basically, he's talking about... So as long as no one goes digging up Jake's guff, and I don't see how the crime can ever be traced back to me.
Looks like the mortician is rather suspicious about Jake.
What could Mayor Cecil, Captain Aureus, or Evelyn have to do with it?
But we have our suspects. But apparently there's no body there. So we're going to go over there and check that out. Because apparently someone took it. So we need to see what he buried then.
Oh man, you better quick save.
I know.
It's party time.
You'd be digging up all these things.
Here lies Jared. Shall I come back as an enraged spirit?
All right.
Or a lovable prince?
Yeah. Magic pocket.
Took my shovel.
Magic pocket. Yay. Oh, look, it's Jared. Oh, shit, Jared. Oh, we're so sorry.
Sorry for what?
Did I blow him up? Oh, fuck. I don't know what happened there.
Oh, yeah, you fucking bitch.
Dude, it was DDoS attack. I don't know what you're talking about. Dude, I'm not wasting two resurrect souls on that shit.
Mysterious lost footage.
You know, we can make a really... Like, Jared was literally a bomb. We can make a lot of insensitive jokes right now. You know that, right?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, we're all thinking it. Let's just say that right now.
I'm just gonna stand back here.
I'm gonna run away. Alright.
Here's the problem. Jared's gonna die.
Okay, as long as one of us lives, it's fine. All right, we're all live. It's intentional. All right, let's talk to each other.
That shovel has proven worth its weight. It seems.
Is that really appropriate?
It's gotten us some good shit.
And I would have done so more quickly if someone weren't hovering over my shoulder like a nosy aunt.
Some of us wouldn't have to hover if others of us weren't prone to rage digging. I'm merely trying to save whatever treasure might be buried before you hack it in half.
Rage digging. It's my turn.
Oh yeah, let me save it before fucking... We know at this point.
I don't know anything.
Whose grave was it even? We don't even know.
Fucking read it later.
These
bones.
Pile of bones.
Here lies Patrick. You can kill me, but you'll never kill the dancer inside me.
What did you loot?
There's nothing on the bones.
Well, you'll never kill the dancer in him.
Here lies Kimberly. Finally.
Alright. Yeah, go on. I'm just gonna stand back. Just more bones.
Bones! Oh, God.
Graveyard. To the graveyard grave diggers, you'll wish you hadn't. I'm all for that.
There's one down here as well. I want to get this one. I'm reading the tomb.
Here lies Catherine. I know. I was great.
Wow. What a cocky cunt. Alright.
Well, there's still one up there, but I'll let you do the next one.
Looks like that dog is awfully agitated.
Perhaps he wants to tell us something.
Okay, I'll talk to the dog.
Fine, go talk to the dog. I won't do any looting.
The dog's amazing, though. So, I'm not sure if Cam can actually hear the dog talking. We're gonna see if he can.
Their days have passed. Hours. I assume you address me for a reason.
Why are you talking to him?
Go on, and so let the hunt continue.
Stop talking to fucking Jen. Yeah, let me talk to the dog.
Talk to the dog, then.
Trying to.
Hey, wow. I was wondering where that awesome sweaty boot smell was coming from, and here you are! Wow! This is great!
I fucking love the dog.
I'm Murphy, Jake's dog. Wow, you smell great! Have you been rolling around on dead things all day? That's my favorite hobby, too.
Tell me about yourself, boy.
You know who I miss? Jake. Sometimes, he'd just sit there being awesome, and I'd give him this look like, you smell great. And he'd give me this look like, you do too, Murphy. And he was my best friend. I came here so I could smell Jake again. He smelled great. But whatever's buried there doesn't smell like Jake at all. No, it's definitely not Jake. He was awesome.
About your master's death, boy.
If I ever find out who killed Jake, the most awesome Jake who ever jaked, I'll bark so much. Seriously, so much. You have no idea.
I gotta go now, boy. Actually, no, we didn't finish
it. Oh, wow. You smell even better than last time. Wow. Amazing. Like the mortician's house during summer. You know who I'm? I came here.
Oh, I don't get to do the thing. Okay, you know what? Actually, I think it's because we have to dig up his grave first.
Where are you, Jake?
Because there's something else
I was talking to Johan.
This dog we met. How true a creature he is. How loyal and unwavering in its affections. His master is dead, but not even this, not even nature's great betrayal of life, stops his warm-heartedness from beating. Animals. Dog and deer, elk and eagle. We burden and butcher them, wretches that we are. These pillars of creation, we topple them, though their spirits are so very pure. They are. They do not scheme. They do not deceive. Perfidy. That is the human condition. This kind, this trusty beast. He is man's best friend, though man does not deserve one.
The fuck? Okay, I guess I'll say humans are but vile creatures. Like, what the fuck? Like, why is he so fucking, like, emo? Like,
edgelord.
Holy shit. Yeah, edgelord, that's a good word for it. The demon edgelord is what he is.
Jake!
Oh, I didn't have a voice for that. Animals are not better than humans, they don't know any better. Quite the difference
rest
of that.
In peace,
I love you, boys.
So, my two options here are I agree and I agree.
Are you playing without me?
I'm inclined to agree. Agreed! No, I think you're agreeing with me or you're agreeing with Johan.
I'm gonna agree with Johan.
Not of the same mind because you are human. All too human. And deep down, you place trust in your fellows. But one day, a stab in the back will tell you I am right. I know. For I have lain on silken cushions in marble palaces, and I have lain on wet leaves in soggy forests. Vastly do I prefer the latter. Oh, the occasional thorn may pierce your skin, but at least you are aware the sting is not that of a poisoned needle hidden by aspiring rivals. In the animal kingdom, only one is free. Beware the wolf, yes, beware the bear, but their rules are honest. The kingdoms of man, they are built upon the blood of the ones not strong enough to lay claim to power.
Holy shit, this guy.
This dog, it is a creature worthy of your affection. The ones you see around you, the men and women of this world, they are not.
Fucking hell, I kind of wanted to get that fucking thief follower just because he shuts the fuck up. And doesn't talk about demons and dogs for hours.
Jake. Please do not disturb.
Please do not disturb. Well, we're gonna disturb
fuck
that.
I was gonna do that.
I'm taking this.
Rest in peace.
Oh, what's in the
trickery is this?
Casket.
That's not Jake.
Where are you?
It's a rotting sheep's
are
corpse.
You here, Jake?
It seems Jake. Someone snatched Jake's body.
So, his corpse isn't here. Let's go talk to the dog again.
That dead sheep smells pretty great. I mean, wow. But it's nothing compared to Jake. Seems like some mutt is marking my territory.
This isn't your master, boy.
Someone stole Jake? Jake stole my ball once, but then he threw it far, and I went and I got it. And Jake was awesome. Listen, if you go around town and find someone who you think might have done it, bring me a really stinky something of theirs. And I'll see if I can smell Jake on it. An awesome smell. I couldn't mistake it.
Come with us. You can help sniff out the guilty party. I would totally replace, like, John with the dog in an instant.
Join you? No way. I mean, you smell pretty great. Even better than the dumpster behind the butcher's house. The town is full of scary stuff like body snatchers and bathtubs. Without my best friend, the most awesome Jake ever, here to protect me, I'd rather stay far away. Just bring those smelly items to me here.
Do you think you could spell whoever killed Jake?
Is Lorelda? Ugh, terrible smell. Like flowers and soap. Not awesome. Ugh, hated her. Aureus is kind of awesome. Evelyn, too. They both have a sweaty, dead thingy smell. Cecil, he's all right, I guess. Mostly, he smells like old books, which is neither awesome nor non-awesome. Bring me anything of theirs, and I'll be able to tell you if I can sniff out Jake's smell on them. Jake has the best smell. I'd know it anywhere. Did you find something for me to stick my nose into?
So we did find two things. It was like the smelly panties from Esmeralda, and I forgot what you just gave me for Cecile. For the mayor. What did you give me, Kent?
Your smelly shoes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's right. I do have those. Okay, so let's try. Let's see if Cecile has the smell of Jake on him.
I've heard people say that politicians stink. Give me a whiff, and I'll be able to tell you if it's a Jake kind of stink. No. Not him. No scent of Jake whatsoever.
So it wasn't Cecile. How about Esmeralda?
Jake was awesome, and she didn't like Jake. So I'm pretty sure she's the worst thing that ever lived. Let me get a whiff. Oh, take this away. It smells like every rich man in town except Jake. No, there's definitely not a hint of Jake here.
Yep, so neither of them actually... Well, according to the dog, neither of them killed Jake, so... Well, let's go then. So those are not the murderers. You want to go dig up more graves?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, go ahead and knock yourself out.
Here lies David, who ran from the Reaper. You'll never catch me alive.
I smell...
No, my shovel.
May the sevens keep you.
Yes!
And I like how the dog joins the fight, too. Oh, fuck, it's Dave.
Yeah, it's Dave!
Fucking Dave. I like how fucking...
He is weak to fire.
I'm good at that. Can he get hit by lightning, at least? Because I'll try and shock him.
Yes.
He's level 8, by the way, guys. We're like level 4, so... But there's a lot of us here, so we should be able to do something with him.
Yeah, we can totally do this.
You got this, Ken.
Right.
Double time.
I forgot which one it was, by the way. I knew one of these had like your guy in there. Alright, who should I damage buff?
Go for Medora.
Alright, let's do Shocking Touch. Oh, good. He's stunned. Okay, this is gonna be easy now.
Fuck you, Dave.
Yeah, Dave. Summon the spider right behind him. Fuck.
That's just spooky.
You have to be careful about AoE because there's like the dog here. We want the dog to live, to be honest. The dog, because that's one of the things as pet paw you can do. You can solve the murder with the dog. Oh, fucking that dog is the best. Dude, he is bleeding too. If he was in our party, I'm sure he'd totally make me bleed and heal myself. Why is Jake the best? Go get him.
Stop
that! Okay, and the random one is coming over.
Don't fucking do it, Mike. Nice.
That's some range he has there. Yeah, we just have poor Dave surrounded.
Get on the ground! Oh wait, I should be using this stance. Missed some damage there, that sucks. Dave is so dead.
There you go. I'll finish him. That's a lot of XP. Thanks, Dave.
Thanks, Grave. Your turn.
Alright. That's what's here.
Here lies Nemris, master of philosophy.
Master of Philosophy. And no one. Oh, shit. Oh, this guy. That's right. Numerous. Oh, fuck, I remember this guy.
Look here.
I'm already looking it up, dude.
Author as renowned as I is flattered when mortals dare among the dead to seek him out. Well, here I am, Nemeris the Wise. You may go wide-eyed with amazement now.
Tell me about yourself.
As if I need introduction. Nemeris the Thinker, the Theorist, the Visionary. Come now, surely you lack the time, as I do, for such silly questions.
You're an author?
Oh, I've written so many celebrated treatises, but of course you have read and revered the philosophy of death, the diamond in the crown that is my literary legacy. There isn't a civilized soul alive that hasn't perused its profound pages, percolating with perspicacity. Alas, that so few show an understanding of my words, so few show the expected intellectual growth when I put them to the test.
Can I read your philosophy of death?
You can, and indeed you must. But alas, I was not buried with a printed version of that blueprint of genius that is my inimitably esteemed essay. Never fear, though, for each and every library in Revelon boasts a copy. The gilded cherry on their paper pie.
I take my leave. We don't have his book yet. Okay, and so we need to find his book. Apparently every library has one, so there's probably a library here has one.
Do you actually want to read the book?
I want to at least get the book to show that we kind of did it.
Okay. Do you want to clear the grave first, or what?
Yeah, we'll do that.
Here lies Kavanagh. Will they have Sisal Pie in the afterlife?
Sisal Pie in the afterlife? Are you playing without me?
That's the bit of the bomb.
Oh, it's Sisal Pie.
Sisal Pie?
from a grave. James, as usual, the filthy fibber. I like how it has like a little fish in there, just sticking out of it.
Jake, where are you? My shovel now. Are you here, Jake? Rest Bones. Darling.
Here lies Jack, the oldest man in Sisal. Get off my grave, you jackanapes.
And just a bone.
Then we got this one. It's not even a grave!
It's a hole, but we're not gonna go in there yet, actually. I think if we dig up her grave, she's gonna get pissed off, though.
Yeah, it's not. But I see the one down here. I think I've missed this before.
Well, I'm gonna read what the grave says, though.
In memory of Loni, death lies on her, like an untimely frost, upon the sweetest flower of all the fields.
Alright, let me go down here and check out what you're doing.
Helen. Killed by an enraged zombie. I'm sure we can talk this out.
Alright, I'm pretty sure the enraged zombie's gonna come out. I actually don't remember this one. Yeah, there you go. Oh god, Helen, why? Oh no, she's a mage.
Spooky level 8 mage. I'm trying to delay my turn, I think.
So you want me to
I can't now.
You want me to buff you and then kind of... I'm gonna thunder jump to him, just telling you, because I'm behind you.
Yeah, I was gonna delay my turn and then, like, attack when you already stunned her, but fuck it. Too late now.
Stunned failed. Add more. You didn't even see what he was weak to.
You're right, stunned. I didn't.
He's stunned anyway.
The skeleton, probably weak to fire, to be honest.
I actually can't tell. To be honest.
Well, you could have checked. You got a lore master ring, remember?
My character does. You're right. I still hear that fucking dog in the background. You know, I can't be mad at him. He's adorable. You know, Candy almost is? Adorable.
You know, hey, look, she's helping. Why isn't the dog helping? What a shit dog.
You take that back. Jake is awesome.
I'll take it back when you stop calling me Pat.
I made him weak. I forget what that even does. Okay, Spider, examine him. Strength negative 2, damage negative 50%.
What do your spider eyes see?
He's got a lot of them, dude. He's like probably the king of Warmaster.
King of dying? Oh god.
Alright. Oh, dude, there's robust mail bracers there. Anyways, guys, that's all the time we got for today. Next time we will carry on. Take care, everyone. Bye.
Bye.